This up and the battle is yours. Zone A lost. Now you're fighting with heart, Guardian. Double down.
3 minutes remaining.
Strength in numbers, Guardian. Excellent. Triple down.
Ladies and gents, my name is Xander, aka Deicide, and in this video, we're going to discuss and review a brand spanking new exotic weapon called the Arbalest, and it just so happens to be the only kinetic linear fusion rifle in the entire game. Just from hearing that one statement and that one statement alone, you can already tell that it's certainly worth its exotic status. But now comes the question that we've all been asking ourselves, and that is the grind actually worth it? To you, Deislayers, I say yes, because not only is this thing extremely fun to use in PvP, but if you happen to like the other exotic fusion rifle known as the Queenbreaker or other sniper rifles in the game, then this thing is easily going to be up your alley, and you just might make enemy guardians a little bit salty. However, before we get everyone's sodium levels so high to the point where McDonald's is going to be asking for their fries back, we've got to know how to be able to get this weapon first. And as you already know, this week happens to be an event called the Revelry. Within the event, we of course have something that's very, very similar to what the Haunted Forest was back in Halloween. And this time around, we have something very, very similar, and all you simply got to do is defeat a couple of Verdant Forest bosses, and eventually you're then going to acquire a currency called Reveler's Essence. In total, you're going to need 300 Reveler's Essence in order to actually obtain this weapon. But on top of that, you also have to complete 7 triumphs within this brand new event called Revelry. As soon as you happen to do both of those things, this Arbalest is going to be yours. But also know that you can actually obtain this currency known as the Reveler's Essence in one of 3 ways. The first is to defeat bosses within the Verdant Forest itself. Second is to complete bounties via Eva Levante, and third is to also complete the other bounty or potential bounties from Tess Eververse. With that, the only thing left to do is to eviscerate that notification button, and let's jump right into video. As you all probably already know, the very first thing that I love to do is I like to look and analyze at a weapon's optimal time to kill and body shot time to kills respectively. But for this Arbalest, it just so happens to be classified as a linear fusion rifle, and with that we then have a charge time. However, this Arbalest is classified as a kinetic weapon and it also happens to take special ammo, unlike every single other linear fusion rifle in the entire game that takes power ammo. Clearly, you can already tell that this thing is certainly worth its exotic status from that one fact and that one fact alone. But whether or not it's actually viable in PvP is what we're going to look at this very second. And so as you have probably already noticed, this thing is dealing around 414 points of damage per a crit and 166 points of damage for a body. Obviously, that 414 points of damage in the head is going to be a one-shot kill every single time for non-super guardians. But unlike sniper rifles, this thing has a charge time, and with that, it's then going to correlate to an optimal time to kill that's going to be at precisely 0.53 seconds optimal TTK. I can certainly say that that time to kill is fantastic, and it's very, very good, but keep in mind that you may not necessarily be going up against other weapons like auto rifles and hand cannons, and rather you're going to be going up against shotguns and other sniper rifles which have an instantaneous time to kill. Furthermore, I just want to go one step further and put this into perspective for you, because the weapons like the Luna's Howl and the Not Forgotten have optimal time to kills at 0.67 seconds, and the Last Word also has an optimal time to kill that's the exact same as this Arbalest at 0.53 seconds. So if you're asking yourselves as whether or not this thing can compete, I would certainly say yes, it definitely can. And if you don't like to snipe, you might want to get this Arbalest a try, because it's very, very similar to what sniping is in conjunction with that of fusion rifles, and so we have this marvelous symbiotic relationship between those two things, and it makes the weapon oh so juicy, oh so crispy, and oh so, so spicy. Having said that, what I also want you to remember is that this thing does 166 points of damage in the body, and so obviously that's not enough to down somebody with one shot. Thus, we're going to need two shots. And when this is the case, the weapon's body shot time to kill is going to be at 1.8 seconds, and that is hideous, despicable, and terrible in so many ways that I can't even begin to describe to you as to how bad that actually is. As you guys can tell from right here, here's all the stats that I just mentioned to you guys right there on screen. And the main thing that I want you to actually take away from this is that I want you to recognize that at the bottom, the charge time is at 533. But also notice that the weapon's optimal TTK is at 0.53 seconds. What I happen to find is that if you take any linear fusion rifle and you take its charge time and divide it by 1000, you're then going to get the weapon's optimal time to kill. And that's going to be very, very consistent across the board. And the reason why I know this is because what I did is I actually took the Arbalest and the Queenbreaker and took them into a private match and just simply shot them at a wall as fast as I possibly could, and then I physically counted as to how many frames was passing in order for a weapon to actually fire a shot. Now, I didn't just do this for the Arbalest, but I did it for the Queenbreaker via its combat sight, which is that very low zoom scope, and then also its marksman sight, which is that long range scope. And the reason why this is so important to note is because right here, you're then going to see a marvelous side-by-side comparison analysis of all these three different characteristics of the two weapons right there on screen. No matter how that you look at this, whether you're looking at the Arbalest, the Queenbreaker with its combat sight there in the center, or the Queenbreaker with its marksman sight there on the right, each one of them is going to take one critical headshot or two body shots to attain the weapon's optimal TTKs or body shot TTKs respectively. Furthermore, I also want you to recognize that the charge times are at 533, 300, and 633 across the board. And in accordance with this, we're then going to take those charge times divided by 1000, and thus we're then going to get the optimal TTKs at 0.53, 0.3, and 0.63 seconds for the Arbalest, the Combat Sight Queenbreaker, and the Marksman Sight Queenbreaker altogether. Knowing all this information, I think that you guys now get a pretty darn good comprehension as to whether or not the Arbalest can actually compete in PvP, and on top of this, as to how it compares to that of the Queenbreaker. But the very next thing that I want to discuss and analyze is all the weapon's perks, and as to really what makes this thing an exotic weapon or classified as an exotic trait weapon, and these two perks just so happen to be Compounding Force and Disruption Break. Compounding Force states that this weapon fires slugs that cause massive damage to elemental shields of enemy combatants. In accordance with this, we also have Disruption Break, and Disruption Break states that breaking an enemy shield with this weapon makes them more vulnerable to kinetic damage for a very short period of time. Remember that the Arbalest is a kinetic linear fusion rifle, and so just from that last perk alone, you guys already know that this thing's then going to do massive amounts of damage as soon as you happen to break enemy guardian shields with the first shot. And so on the second shot, you're then going to do a tremendous amount of critical damage if you just so happen to land one of those shots. And to see this firsthand, I happen to have a perfect example to show you. As you guys can tell from right here, I've just taken my first shot, which just so happens to be a body shot against this guardian. As I take my next shot, it becomes a critical headshot, and oh my goodness gracious, you guys can see from right there that this thing has just done 620 points of damage in the head, and I'm not gonna lie, as soon as I saw that, I was like, holy crap. That thing is mind-boggling and actually quite excessive, but the very next question that we had to ask ourselves is whether or not this effect is going to come into play against enemy guardians while in their super. After going up against many guardians in their supers, regardless of whether or not it was an Arc Strider, it was a Spectral Blade, it was a Sunbreaker, it was a Stormcaller, whatever the case may have been, I can definitely guarantee you that even though this effect still applies, it's not nearly as severe. And the reason why it is so is because it's going to take at least two shots for you to even break their shield. And on that third shot, that's when you might be able to have some massive damage. Now, I'm not gonna lie, I don't see this being very, very effective, at least when you're in a 1v1 engagement against another super. But where I do see this Compounding Force and Disruption Break synergy perks coming together is when you're in a team shot environment. And when this is the case, that enemy guardian who just so happens to be in their super is going to get eradicated, obliterated, and decimated, and before they even know it, they're gonna go poof up into a flame of smoke, thinking, what the heck just happened? Understanding this, The very next thing we have to cover is the weapon's other perks besides compounding force and disruption break. As you guys can see from right here, the weapon has extended barrel, projection fuse, and composite stock. And taking into account all these perks that I just mentioned with the weapon's base stats, we're then going to get all the values that you guys see right there on screen. And the most notable about all these things is the weapon's range at 62 out of 100, its handling speed at a despicable 27 out of 100, a decent aim assistance at 61, and a marvelous recoil direction at 87 out of 100. Hearing these values, I want to focus first upon range and range alone. And the reason why having such a high range value at 62 out of 100 is exceptional for this Arbalest is because the weapon is then going to have a very high bullet magnetism. And so what that's then going to entail for you is that even if you happen to miss a critical headshot by just a couple of inches, the bullet still might actually hit, and that's because this range value is so high. Now for the Arbalest specifically, I found that this was very much so the case whenever I was in those close range to mid range engagements. But whenever I got outside of that to say the longer range engagements, that's when I found that the bullet magnetism wasn't quite nearly as good. But even so, what this weapon also has going for it is the aim assistance at 61 out of 100. And so with these two things combined via the bullet magnetism and aim assistance, it just makes those longer range engagements ever so slightly easier to land those critical headshots. However, there is one huge elephant in the room, and that is the weapon's handling speed, which is an atrocious 27 out of 100. And the reason why I say that this is so terrible is because not only is that ADS time quite noticeable, but also, this is the sole primary reason as to why this Arbalest has an astronomical and skyrocketing amount of flinch, and if you were to ask me, it's probably the worst flinch that I have ever seen out of any other linear fusion rifle in the entire game. For those of you that may or may not know, handling speed has a direct correlation to flinch, and the higher weapon's handling is, the less flinch a weapon's going to take. And the same thing can also be said vice versa, in that the lower a weapon's handling speed is, the more flinch it's going to take, and this is unfortunately the case for the Arbalest. Thus, I have my number one tip for you on how to use this Arbalest, and that is in order for you to use it effectively and to get around this flinch factor, what you have to do is time perfectly the ADS time with the weapon's charge time so that as soon as you happen to aim down sights, you're only showing that sight for a split second, and then by the time that you even know it, the bullet's off, it's flown, it's landed that critical headshot, and you have absolutely no time to really take flinch because you're only aiming down sights for that split second. Speaking of the weapon sights, what I just want to do very quickly is I want to mention one of the huge assets that this Arbalest has in comparison to say something like a sniper rifle is its actual sight. And so as I put the game on pause right here, you guys can tell that this sight is going to be exceptional because not only does it have an incredibly low zoom factor, but it has some of the best peripheral vision that you could possibly ask for, and that's then going to allow you to go from one target onto the next, duck and dive into cover, be able to make very good educated guesses as to where their enemy guardians are going to be next, and so this is then going to make the weapon much more versatile for a wider variety of engagements, whether that be close, mid, or far, it doesn't matter. Taking one more step back, I actually want to take one more comparison of the Arbalest in contrast to that of the Queenbreaker with its combat-based sight and the marksman sight, because each one of these things is very different, and as you guys can tell, here's all the differences right there on screen. The most notable about all these differences is that the weapon has different range factors, which is then going to in turn affect each one of these weapons' bullet magnetism. Not just that, but the weapon's handling speed is also drastically different, and that's then going to once again entail as to how much flinch that each one of these fusion rifles is then going to have too. Having heard all this information in a very short amount of time, I can definitely say that you now know the ins and outs of the Arbalest as well as the contrasting comparisons to the Queenbreaker. And so the only thing that I have left to say is that this weapon is a learned weapon. At first, I was getting decimated and absolutely obliterated so much to the point that I was even getting teabagged on a very regular basis. But the reason as to why that was is because I didn't understand how the appropriate timing worked with the charge time and the aim down sight time to avoid the flinch factor. Once I got that timing down, this flame right here was making enemy guardians' cholesterols go skyrocketing through the roof, and needless to say, no one was teabagging me anymore. But having said that, I want to hear your guys' thoughts on this down in the comment section below, and whether or not you like the weapon, you don't, you agree with my assessment that it's awesome, you despise it, you don't want to ever touch it again, and no matter what the case may be, you guys can always give your opinion and know that it's always going to be respected. Lastly, be sure to watch the newest, check the latest, and share a comment like on social media, because you are the greatest. That's pretty much all I've got for you as of right now, Deislayers. And as always, GG, TNT.